Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and the Android 11 April 2021 update is now available for all supported Pixel devices, as well as Android One devices and many Samsung devices as well, although it's up to your manufacturer to push that out. So you may be seeing it already if you're on a different manufactured Android device, or it may be some time, but it's up to your manufacturer. Now, if you have a Pixel, it's supported on Pixel 3, Pixel 3a, Pixel 4, Pixel 4a, Pixel 4a 5G, Pixel 5, and all the XL variants of those phones. You can see all the build numbers here. And if we take a look at the build number on this device, which is the Pixel 5, we'll wait for it to come back around and you'll see it says 11RQ2A.210405.005. And that's on the Pixel 5. It may be different for you, but I also have Android 12 on the Pixel 4a XL. Since I've been using that, it has some bugs. It's an early developer preview, but right now it's got some bugs, but has some interesting changes in it that I covered in a separate video. And if you'd like to see more of those videos, I post those regularly. So make sure you're subscribed and also hit that notification bell if you'd like to be notified. I cover Android and iOS as well. Now, as far as the overall size of this update, well, it's fairly small. So if we go and take a look at one of my screenshots from this, it was 15.19 megabytes on the Pixel 5. So it's fairly small, but has a very important update if you're on a Pixel 5, for example. I'll talk about that in just a moment, but something else Google announced today is new experiments. It's sort of like a feature drop, but not really a feature drop. It works on any device that supports augmented reality, and it's WebXR experiments. Experiments.withgoogle.com. I'll link it in the description. But it talks about what it is. You've got different things like Flume, Sodar, Measure Up. You can measure using your camera, Picturescape, and more. So we'll go into Flume, for example, and it gives you an idea of what it is. Now, since this is a desk, it's a little bit hard to get this to recognize, but you can play around with this on any augmented reality area and just try it out for yourself. So it's pretty interesting, these different things they've included, but I'll link those in the description. Now, as far as what's changed or what's been fixed, the first thing has to do with the Pixel 4a 5G and Pixel 5, and that is improvements for camera quality in certain third-party apps. Now, Google doesn't say what third-party apps those are, but it is available and should fix any issues you were having. Hopefully it wasn't bothering any issues you were having. I think the stock camera app is probably my favorite since it seems to take the best photos, but if you have a third-party app and we're having issues, it should be resolved. Now, the next thing they've fixed is on all supported Pixel devices. So that has to do with connectivity. If you were having issues with connectivity, what they've fixed is issues causing certain devices to appear offline when you're using a VPN or when you're connected to a VPN. That's on everything from the Pixel 3 and 3 XL up to the Pixel 5. So that should be resolved in this one. Now, the next one is big for the Pixel 5 and 4a 5G, and they've given it some performance optimizations for certain graphic intensive apps and games. However, AnandTech, for example, has said performance has essentially doubled on the Pixel 5. So as far as that goes, we can take a look at 3D Mark, and you'll see I scored 1,663 with Wildlife on 3D Mark. And this seems to be higher than most people based on what it says here, your score versus this model, 99%. Your score is better than 99% of scores for the Pixel 5. So they've really increased performance. If you're running this update, I'd say it's essential as far as that part goes. So that's been resolved in this particular update. Now, the next thing they've fixed has to do with the system overall, and it's for the Pixel 4 through the Pixel 5. So 4, 4A, 4A, 5G, 5, and the XL variants. They've fixed an issue causing certain devices to freeze on the Google logo during startup. So if you're booting up and you've got the G in the center and it just wouldn't continue to boot, you'd have to restart a couple times. That should be resolved. And the final fix that they have is a fix for missing home screen grid settings in certain devices. And that covers the Pixel 3, 3 XL, 3A, 3A XL, 4, 4 XL, and 4A. So if you were having issues where you would go to styles and wallpapers, maybe go to grid, and some of the options just weren't there on those devices, they should be present now. So those are all the fixes that they have in this update, but they've also fixed a bunch of or patched a bunch of security issues. And let me run down those quickly. They've patched 11 framework issues, 3 media framework, 8 system updates, 1 Google Play system update, 2 kernel updates, 1 MediaTek component, 3 Qualcomm components and 12 Qualcomm closed source components. All of those things have been patched in this update as far as security goes. So you want to make sure you're updated. And that leads me to, should you install this update? Well, I would say absolutely, unless you're doing something custom, install this. Not only will it give you better performance on the 5, for example, or the 4A 5G, it will also give you better security and optimize things like your camera, again, in the 5 and the 4A 5G. So all of those things are patched, and I definitely recommend installing this. Now, as far as performance and the little time that I've used it, I haven't noticed any slowdowns other than that quick stutter that you saw right there, but maybe it's still doing something in the background as far as processing. But overall, it seems to be very fast compared to what it was before. It's incredibly fast when you're in games, for example, and it seems to be really improved compared to what we had before. With this processor on the Pixel 5. So I'm looking forward to using this a little bit more and seeing how its battery is as well. But let's take a quick look at what battery was like on the March update. So if we go into battery here, we'll go to battery usage. We'll give it just a moment. And it says it has a 1 day and 5 hours left. And it said 3 days ago is when I fully charged it. And this is a phone I don't use 100% of the time. It's more of a secondary phone that I use for emergency and business. So it's been working really well. I haven't had any crashes, no app issues, nothing like that. So I use it for social media quite a bit and for Google News and all sorts of things. It seems to work really well. And of course I use it for the camera because this is a phenomenal camera. So overall, I think it's a great update. I'm glad to see that they made the performance what it should have been when it launched. Hopefully it's better for you as well, but let me know your experience in the comments below. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.